My name is Antonio Sarasa, and I'm going to present this paper, Consumer Annotation Tools, Annotation Classification Mechanics. This paper about documents annotation tools. With these tools, the students can associate annotation with fragments of the documents, and these tools facilitate some activities of the learning process. For example, analysis of content, objective thinking, collaborative annotation among students, etc. These tools provide a mechanism for classifying annotations which are essential in order to retrieval of relevant annotations, evaluate or work done by students, and other activities. In this paper, we can describe a study about the mechanics for classification, for classifying annotations. This study has some restrictions. It's limited to the tools oriented to annotations of documents. It was used reference surveys in the subject and free excerpts of primary scientific sources, for example, ScienceDirect, ACM Data Library, and others. And it was selected 38 annotation tools. In this study, we can see that ICE was identified five main annotation classification strategies. Tools that lack a specific classification strategy, a classification based on presentational attribute, another tools classification based on predefined semantic categories, classification about based on the use of polysonomies, and another based on the use ontologies. We can see its strategies. The first strategy tools that lack a specific classification mechanics. The main characteristic in this approach is that there isn't any specific mechanics for classification annotations. In this way, these tools prioritize other aspects, such as more natural integration mechanics. Some tools use this strategy. For example, is digital learning desk, like notes, and other tools. The second strategy, or the second classification, is classification based on presentational attributes. In this approach, the tools use the different ways of annotation a document in order to define an implicit categorization of the annotation. For example, underlining, highlighting, or explicit text. The main characteristic of this classification is that the categories use the presentational attribute of the annotation and not the semantic of the annotations. Some tools about this classification are Adobe Reader, PDF Annotator, and other tools. The next classification is a classification based on predefined semantic categories. In this approach, the tools use a set of categories based on semantic stack for annotation classification. The main characteristics in this classification is that the tags are related to the semantics of annotations and not to the presentation characteristics. Some tools are low highlight a punch to zero and another tools. The next is a classification based on the use of polysonomies. In this approach, we use the polysonomies. For example, highlighter, hypothesis, and a note. And the last classifications is a classification based on the use of ontologies. In this approach, we use the ontology to represent the different aspects of the annotation process. For example, learn, the DB knows, memo note, and another tools. In this study represents the actual tendency about in this domain, because we didn't prioritize one type of the tool over another. In this picture we can see the distribution, the tools, about the number of tools analyzed per notation classification method. In this picture we can see that the predominant tool type is the tools on annotation models. The next tools are the tools based on predefined set of semantic categories, and finally the tools based on taxonomies and ontologies. From educational point of view, we can see that the tools lacking specific classification and only enable presentation attribute are not very convenient from an educational point of view. The reasons are they imitate conventional pen and paper based annotation mechanics, and it has a negative impact on learners. Tools supporting a set of predefined semantic categories for classification is better from about the tools, because it can useful for students, because they must reflect on the purpose of the annotations, and they can offer mindful criteria for retrieving annotations. And the main limitations in the approach is the predefined character of these categories. The next tools, the tools supporting functioning, they promote the reflection during the annotation process, and the main limitation is to delegate the collaborative design of this functioning to the learners. And the last tools are better from the educational point of view, because it's possible to calculate specific knowledge about annotations, it provides a high degree of contextualization of the tool to its specific activity, and another reasons. And the main limitations is the need to the background in computer science or knowledge engineering. Conclusions. We have done an exploratory study of annotations classification mechanics. It was analyzing 38 document annotation tools. And from the point of view of educational use, the tools that allow the semantic classification are more appropriate. We have found a high percentage of tools that don't pay attention to this aspect of semantic classifications. And the future work, the study can be expanded by considering tools for the annotation of other types of media, for example, margins or videos, and the analysis can be useful when designing new annotation tools for educational purposes. Thank you very much. Thank you.